Well, it's a. I had a. Well, it's a pleasure to see you guys and to be the guys that sit between you and your Thanksgiving break. So hopefully the exam went okay. Yeah, hopefully it wasn't too bad. It looked from your grades like it was reasonably hard, but not impossible, which is what we aim for around here. As Linda just mentioned, our goal is to have your exam grades out this evening. As a reminder, well, of course, I strongly encourage you guys to all stick to it through the end of the semester. The drop deadline is tomorrow, so should there be an emergency, or if you have anything you want to discuss, you should feel free to reach out to me and we can talk about it. But I didn't, with the exception of one or two exams, it seemed like you guys did reasonably well, which is great. Your grades will be out this evening. If you guys have, and your project things were already due, can this wait until the end of lecture? Your project proposals were due last week, so I will try to send feedback on all of those by Friday. That's how I'll spend my Thanksgiving. So look for an email from me personally, and I'll send you your grade as well as a few comments on your proposal. Right. So as a reminder, essentially your only deliverables left in this class are a few more of the nano quizzes. And your final project, right? So you have a milestone where we ask you to essentially think to turn in about a page of writing telling us just how it's going, and to send a screenshot because it's a graphics class and we'd like some evidence that you've written some graphics code. And then your final project is a presentation of a short write-up. That doesn't need to be, I was going to say the Declaration of Independence, but that's actually not that long, right? Like out of a War and Peace. So are there any questions about logistics or anything else? I will have office hours tomorrow morning, and of course it will be a pleasure to see all of your faces there, although I'm betting that it will be pretty quiet. Yes?
When the where is the gallery?
When we post them.
Okay.
Yeah. It is really informative, yes. Sorry, you have a very busy professor who's not. Any other questions? Actually, not sarcastic questions. It's preferred by me. In that case, let's get started with today's lecture on hardware architecture. Yeah. So, as you guys can probably guess, given your instructor's theoretical bias, this is one of his least favorite and most uncomfortable topics ever. So if there's something vague, it probably is because I don't know. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to be forthright about that fact. In case you haven't caught on, in every class you take at MIT, there's a lecture like this, whether the instructor tells you that or not. So we're going to be honest about it, and I try my hardest to understand this. And if there are a few vague things, then we'll work through it together. Okay, that's our agreement. And the reason why this is like my least favorite topic is because literally every 5 minutes this topic changes. Yeah, and that's simultaneously really exciting and cool, and it's also terrifying as an instructor because it means no matter what you say, it's going to be out of date. Yeah, and in fact, every time NVIDIA comes out with a new card, and ATI, and now Intel every once in a while, they have some new architecture with the latest cool hyper multi mega threading. Technology, which of course is this essentially cobweb of different pipes that all feed data into some very specialized CPU in a slightly different way. And so we're going to talk about some of the basics of how graphics hardware is engineered and how people go about thinking about engineering sort of the path and of data as it moves through your GPU, from the hardware memory into eventually the screen, really, or the buffers that displace them. So today we'll talk a little bit about the evolution of the computer graphics pipeline. We'll have lots of nostalgic images that I'll be really excited about, and you guys just probably happened before you were born. And we'll talk about throughput-optimized parallel processor design. The idea here being that, your graphics card, again, there's this magic number, right, which is 29.97 frames per second, that if you don't hit, all of a sudden your video game, or your operating system, by the way, has latency, right? Meaning that like you can observe chunkiness, and that's what you want to avoid. And so essentially the way that the GPU is designed is very different from the CPU, right, from the central processing unit of the computer, because the CPU's job is to do really, really complicated stuff efficiently, but the main priority is to finish, right? The priority here is to just jam as much data into the pipe and have it come out as quickly as possible. Yeah, and so the way that people optimize and think about this pipeline is quite different from the way that you might learn about how the CPU works in computer architecture class. Yeah? And in particular, we're going to try and take a look at NVIDIA's GPU architecture, and if I get myself balled up and confused, because I read the specs last weekend and it sucked. When we get ourselves confused and upset, we're just going to call out and have a nice Thanksgiving. Okay, that's our plan for today. Yeah? But we can start with the topics that actually matter here, and that's sort of understanding what makes this problem interesting and hard, and what are the basic themes in designing an architecture for your graphics processor. Yeah? And so one of the ways that we can learn about this, and basically learn about the increasing complexity of graphics cards, is to look back a little bit. And the kind of interesting thing here is that really the evolution of graphics hardware follows the evolution of the algorithms that we discussed in this class, right? As they've increased in complexity, we've needed more and more specialized and interesting software. And so what happened is there's this sort of interesting parabola in the history of computer graphics, right? Where originally, of course, graphics was implemented just on your CPU, right? On the same part of your computer that was doing all the calculations, right? And then people realized that there's a lot of patterns in computer graphics that are repeated a lot, and maybe we should make a specialized card that can handle